Everyone, I'm gonna talk about Parkinson's and my experience with tango dancing. Like many of you, you've probably heard that two exercises that are really good for you are boxing and dancing. There was a Parkinson's boxing program in the area, but it wasn't too near me, so I decided to take dance classes. So, in the studio that I dance at, you kind of have to do other dances too because it's a ballroom dance studio. So I do tango along with other dances. And what I've learned is that in Parkinson's, they've studied a lot specifically with tango. So I'm not really sure if the other ballroom dances help, and I'm sure they do. I don't really see a difference in the dancing because I think like some dances, like the Latin dances, are extremely hard for me to do because they're fast, so you have to be fast, think, and move your body a certain way. So I think that would be just as hard and just as challenging for someone with Parkinson's. As far as the tango, I think they highly recommend it because there's been lots of research studies on it. And it's also, I think, recommended because the dance is sort of random, meaning that with the tango, you never really know what your partner's gonna be doing. So that actually is making your session sort of like a forced exercise session. And I know I've read that forced exercise for us with Parkinson's, it's much better than just a regular exercise that you do the same thing all the time because it does build our skills. Also with the dance, I think it helps that you have a partner to initiate the movement. So that really helps out because I don't move automatically. So when that person is initiating the movement for me, it's a lot easier and I can complete the movement. So there's a lot that I want to talk about as far as dance, but this is just an introductory into a series that I'm going to be doing about ballroom and tango dancing. So just wanted to basically explain to you right now why dancing is recommended. Thank you.